Hello students, in this class we are going to discuss about the tuned amplifiers. So in this we are going to discuss about the tuned amplifiers and the Q factors, small signal tuned amplifier, the capacitive single tuned amplifier and double tuned amplifiers. So single tuned amplifiers and double tuned amplifiers we are going to discuss. After that we are going to discuss about effect of cascading single tuned amplifier on bandwidth and effect of cascading double tuned amplifiers on bandwidth and stagger tuned amplifiers and stability of tuned amplifiers. First of all, what is this tuned amplifier? So these tuned amplifiers are tuned for some particular frequency, and those frequencies only will get amplified by this amplifier. Then what is the necessity of using the tuned amplifiers? I will explain you by taking one example. So we all are know FM radios. So the frequency range of FM is 88 megahertz to 108 megahertz. So in this frequency range there are so many FM stations broadcasting their radios, but our receiver, like our radio, has to receive only a particular channel, suppose say 92.7 or 93.5, and remaining frequencies should be eliminated, or it should not be amplified and should not appear across our loudspeaker. Yes or no? So if all frequencies get amplified, means we are unable to listen any single FM station. That's why we have to amplify only a particular frequency. So in order to do that, we have some special type of an amplifiers which are tuned to some particular frequency, which can able to amplify those particular frequencies, is called as tuned amplifiers. So these tuned amplifiers contains the tuned circuit in the collector circuit. Okay, let us see introduction for the tuned amplifiers. In these tuned amplifiers, resistive load is replaced with the tuned circuit, which is capable of amplifying the signal over a narrow band of frequencies centered at FR. In these amplifiers, the resistive load in the load can be replaced with a tuned circuit, like LNC tuned circuit is replaced the resistive load. So it amplifies only a narrow band of frequencies. Narrow band in the sense small range of frequencies, very very small. So small range of frequencies only will be amplified by this amplifier. So the amplifier tuned to some particular frequency, that is called FR, resonance frequency of that tuned coil. The definition for the tuned amplifier is given as the amplifier with the tuned circuit as load is called tuned amplifier or narrow band amplifier. This tuned amplifier is also called as narrow band amplifier. The amplifier which contains the tuned circuit as a load is called tuned amplifier or narrow band amplifier. The center frequency may range from 1 megahertz to many megahertz in this tuned amplifiers, and side frequencies extended from 5 to 10 kilohertz for amplitude modulated voice signals or music, and several hundred kilohertz for other amplification. So we are not only amplifying that particular frequency FR, so we are amplifying some side frequencies also just below and above the center frequency FR. Those frequencies range is 5 to 10 kilohertz in the case of amplitude modulated voice or music, and it may be up to several hundred kilohertz for other amplification types. The parallel tuned circuit is shown in the below figure. So this is a parallel LC tuned circuit. So the resonant frequency is given as FR is equal to 1 by 2 pi root of LC, and where the impedance ZR is L by RC. This is a figure which shows the frequency response of a tuned circuit. So in this figure, we can observe that at the center frequency or resonance frequency FR, we are getting the maximum frequency response. This tuned amplifier will amplify the frequencies between FL and FH and rejects all other frequencies. And in this range also, at center frequency or resonance frequency, we will get the maximum frequency response. Remaining, we will get a low frequency response, sharp decaying or sharp falling frequency response. Okay, so in this graph, one thing is the minus 3 dB bandwidth is denoted as B, and this is the line minus 30 dB frequency response, minus 30 dB frequency response, which is denoted as S. Therefore, the skip selectivity is given as S by B, where S is the minus 30 dB bandwidth and B is the minus 30 dB bandwidth. At resonance, the inductive and capacitive effects of tuned circuit will cancel each other. Therefore, the circuit will look like a resistive circuit, and the cos phi is equal to 1, where the voltage and current both are in phase. Okay, so at resonant circuit, the circuit will act as a resistive circuit, and above FR, the circuit will behave like a capacitive circuit, and below the resonant frequency, the circuit behaves like an inductive circuit. At resonance frequency, the tuned circuit behaves like a resistive, and hence it is used as a load in amplifiers. Next, we are going to discuss about coil losses. The coil is not purely inductive, it consists of few losses represented by leakage resistance in series with the inductor. So in this figure, we can observe the inductive coil is not a purely inductor, it may consist some leakage resistance R. Okay, this leakage resistance R is in series with the inductive coil. The total losses in the coil can be represented as, or it is a summation of, the copper losses, eddy current losses and hysteresis losses. So let us see what is copper losses and eddy current losses and hysteresis losses one by one. The copper losses is inversely proportional to the frequency. So the frequency increases, the copper losses decreases. In order to eliminate the copper losses, we have to increase the frequency of operation, then we won't get any copper losses. Next loss is eddy current loss. The eddy current loss is due to the current flowing in the core caused by the induction. These losses are directly proportional to frequency. So this eddy current losses is occurring due to the current flowing in the core of the coil. Okay, when the current is flowing in the core, these eddy current losses will occur. Okay, so and these eddy current losses are directly proportional to the frequency, so that if the frequency is increased, then the eddy current losses is also increases. Then the last one is hysteresis loss is proportional to the area enclosed by the hysteresis loop and to rate at which the loop traverses. Okay, these hysteresis losses is different from eddy current losses. So these hysteresis losses occurs due to magnetizing and demagnetization of the core. Okay, the eddy current losses will occurs due to the current flowing through the core, and hysteresis losses occurs due to the magnetization and demagnetization of the core. That is the difference between these two. And these hysteresis losses are independent of the frequency. Next, we will see about the Q factor. Here the Q stands for quality. The quality factor which gives the efficiency of a coil, inductive coil. The quality factor is the ratio of reactance to resistance, and it is a unitless parameter. Higher the value of a Q, lower the losses in the inductor. So if the Q factor or quality factor value is large, then that circuit is stable and the losses in the inductor is less. If the Q value is less, then the losses in the inductor are more. Okay. And one more thing, the Q does not have any units. The Q is also defined as measure of efficiency with which the inductor can store the energy. This is a one more definition for the Q factor. The Q factor is given as Q is equal to 2 pi into maximum energy stored per cycle divided by energy dissipated per cycle. The Q factor in a series circuit is given as inductive impedance Q is equal to omega Ls divided by Rs. In the case of parallel circuit, the inductive admittance is defined. The Q is equal to Rp divided by omega Lp. Okay, this is the equations in order to calculate the Q factor. Next thing, the dissipation factor. The dissipation factor D is the total loss within a component and is defined as reciprocal of quality factor. So that we can define the Q in terms of the dissipation factor, Q is equal to 1 by dissipation factor, which is equal to omega Ls by Rs in the case of series circuit. In the case of parallel circuit, Rp by omega Lp. Next is loaded and unloaded quality factor. So what is meant by loaded and unloaded quality factor? We will see. The tank circuit is not connected to the load, then that is called as unloaded quality. At that time, if you calculate the Q factor, that is called as unloaded Q. When the tank circuit is connected to some external resistance, then that is called as loaded quality factor. So when the tank circuit is not connected to any external circuit or load, the Q accounts for internal losses and it is known as unloaded quality factor Q suffix U, and is defined as QU is equal to 2 pi into maximum energy stored per cycle divided by energy dissipated per cycle in the tank circuit. So the unloaded quality factor is the quality factor is calculated when load is not connected to our circuit. So the losses occurring in this case is due to the internal losses of tank circuit. When the tank circuit is connected to the load, then the load quality factor QL is defined as QL is equal to 2 pi into maximum energy stored per cycle divided by energy dissipated per cycle in the tank circuit plus energy dissipated per cycle due to the presence of external load. Okay, so the energy dissipated is occurring due to tank circuit and due to the presence of external load. Only the denominator will get changes for the unloaded and loaded quality factor. The QL load quality factor is applicable for the practical scenarios and it determines the 3 dB bandwidth for the resonant circuit. Therefore, the bandwidth is given by the resonant frequency divided by the loaded quality factor. From this equation, we can say the bandwidth and the loaded quality factor both are inversely proportional. So when the bandwidth is more, the quality factor is less. Or else we can say if the quality factor is large, then the bandwidth is narrow. If the quality factor is small, then the bandwidth will be large. From this diagram, we can understand the selectivity of our tuned amplifiers. This is the bandwidth high quality factor circuit and it is the response for low quality factor circuit. If the quality factor is high value, then the selectivity is more. Actually, in these two node amplifiers, we have to amplify the particular frequency FR only along with some side frequencies which are between FL to FH2. Okay, therefore, in our case, bandwidth should be less in order to select the particular frequency in order to improve the selectivity of the circuit. In the case of low quality factor circuit, the bandwidth is more. You can observe FH1 minus FL1 is a large value, so that the selectivity of our circuit will decreases. We have to select only high quality factor circuit in order to get more selectivity. Let us see the requirements in tuned amplifiers. The basic requirements of a tuned amplifier is given as the amplifier should provide selectivity of resonant frequency over narrow band. As I told earlier, the bandwidth should be narrow in order to get more selectivity. So the selectivity should be more for the tuned amplifiers. The signal should be amplified equally well at all frequencies in the selected narrow band. And one more requirement in the tuned amplifiers is all frequencies should be amplified equally, which means that the resonant frequency and side frequencies, all frequencies must be amplified with the same amplification factor in order to eliminate the non-linearities. The tuned circuit should be mounted where it can be easily tuned. Suppose in a circuit, we have to place the tuned circuit where we can easily change the tuned frequency. In the case of more than one tuned circuit, there should be an arrangement to tune all circuits simultaneously. So some circuits may contain more than one tuned circuit. In that case, we have to make some extra circuit or make some arrangement in order to tune circuits simultaneously. The amplifiers must provide the simplicity in tuning of amplifier components to desired frequency over a considerable range of band of frequencies. So, which means that these amplifiers must provide simplicity in tuning. So, only one component should be varied in order to tune the amplifier. Suppose if more than one component has to vary, means the circuit complexity will increases. So these circuits should be selected in order to easily tune the circuit to some other frequency. Let us see why this requirement is needed. Because as we already discussed one example, FM stations. There are so many FM stations, but we have to select one particular frequency in order to listen that radio channel. Suppose if I am listening 92.7 FM station, thereafter sometime I have to tune to 93.5 frequency in order to listen another broadcasting channel. So that's why the simplicity is most needed, because if the simplicity is more, then we can easily switch from one particular frequency to another particular frequency. Let us see the classification of two node amplifiers. These two node amplifiers are mainly classified into three types. One is single tuned amplifiers, second one double tuned amplifiers, and third one staggered tuned amplifiers. These amplifiers are further classified according to the coupling mechanism used. Suppose if you take our amplifier is a multi-stage amplifier, then based on the coupling mechanism we used, these amplifiers are again classified into capacitor coupled two node amplifier, inductive coupled two node amplifier, transformer coupled tuned amplifiers. These are all the classification of tuned amplifiers. Let us see the advantages and disadvantages of tuned amplifiers. First of all, we will see about advantages. 1. Output signal to noise ratio is good. So, the S by N ratio is good in tuned amplifiers so that we will get less noise. Second advantage is these tuned amplifiers are suitable for the radio transmitters and receivers. As discussed in an example, these tuned amplifiers are mostly used in radio transmitters and receivers too. And the third advantage is amplifies defined frequencies. So these amplifiers only amplifies those particular or defined frequencies only, so that we can select the channel easily. The band of frequencies over which amplification is required can be varied, and by just varying some single component like L value or C value, in most of the cases we will vary only C value. So with that we can easily change the required frequency, required band of frequencies. That is the advantage of tuned amplifier. Let us see the disadvantages of tuned amplifiers. As we are using inductors and capacitors in the tuning circuit, it becomes bulky and costly. Firstly, the inductors are bulky devices and are costlier too. So because of that, the tuned amplifiers are becoming costlier and bulky devices. If the band of frequencies is increased, then design becomes complex. Suppose the band of frequencies are increasing means if we have to amplify more bands, then the circuit will become complex. And third disadvantage is these tuned amplifiers are not suitable to amplify audio frequencies. These all are advantages and disadvantages of tuned amplifiers. Let us see applications of tuned amplifiers. These tuned amplifiers are used in radio receivers to amplify a particular band of frequencies for which the radio receivers is tuned. So, in radio receivers as well as radio transmitters, we use these tuned amplifiers in order to amplify those particular band of frequencies. The class B and class C amplifiers used as an output RF amplifier in radio transmitter to increase the output efficiency and to reduce the harmonics. As we know that the class C in some class C and class B type of amplifiers are containing the tuned circuits at the output in order to improve the efficiency, so that we can improve the efficiency of an amplifier using tuned circuit. Used in active filters such as low pass, high pass and band pass to allow amplification of signal only in desired narrow band. In some cases of filters, low pass, high pass and band pass, if you want to pass only a particular frequency, that time we use the tuned amplifiers. Used as very narrow band IF amplifier in spectrum analyzers. Even in spectrum analyzers, these tuned amplifiers are used for the narrow band IF intermediate frequency amplifier. And these tuned amplifiers used as intermediate frequency amplifier in a satellite transponder. So, transponder in the sense which receives the signals and retransmits again. So, at that time, we have to use some intermediate frequencies. Even in satellites also, we use these tuned amplifiers.